Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. So our lesson today is about annuity. So actually annuity ni, this one is the extended from compound interest. So nanti kita tengok macam mana dia punya konsep, okay? So learning objective here, able to differentiate compound interest and annuity, and then explain the terms ordinary annuity certain, derive the future value and the present value of ordinary annuity certain, and solve for annuity payment, the number of payments and the interest rate. Yes, so annuity ni ada banyak, ada bermacam-macam jenis, tapi korang hanya belajar yang ordinary annuity certain. Okay, so this one, so type of annuity. So we have annuity due, annuity certain, general annuity and perpetuity. But you only learn the ordinary annuity certain. Okay, so what is annuity actually? So annuity is series of equal payment of deposits made at regular interval or period. Okay, sebagai contoh macam compound interest dulu, kita invest pada awal sahaja, mula-mula sahaja, compound interest. Okay, so compound interest, before that, so we put money at the beginning, at here sahaja, dalam ni sahaja, and then we find S here. Okay, and there is another one which is special case, so we add another money at the middle, we add or we subtract. Okay, so but this one in annuity, so annuity this one, we put money in regular interval. Okay, so we find S at, still find S at the end. Actually, there is two. One, we find S, which is what we call it, future value, and one more is present value A here. Okay, only the difference from annuity and compound interest. Dulu masa compound interest kita letak awal sahaja. But here we have regular payment. Okay, so at the regular interval, we put money R and so on. Okay, so this one R represent as a regular payment ataupun periodic payment. Okay, okay, so situation that use annuity, EPF. Okay, so the employer di provident fund, KWSP ni. So KWSP biasanya dia akan potong gaji pekerja tiap-tiap bulan untuk disimpan. Okay, so macam KWSP ni pun dia akan memberikan interest kepada penyimpan-penyimpan dia. Okay, so contohnya bulan pertama. So bulan pertama dia potong, and then bulan kedua dia potong, bulan ketiga dia potong, bulan keempat dia potong, lima dan seterusnya. So each money that they take from the worker for each month will produce each interest. So setiap duit yang ada dalam, yang dipotong tiap-tiap bulan ni, akan menghasilkan interest. Only in term of calculation, so cara nak kira dia, takkan kita nak kira satu-satu. So nanti kita tengok macam mana. And here also same, amanah saham Bumi Putra, which is saving by monthly salary deduction. So ESB ni, kalau dia buat potongan gaji tiap-tiap bulan, dia akan jadi annuity. Tapi ESB kalau korang just simpan awal tahun masukkan duit, pertengahan tahun masukkan duit, tu dia takkan jadi lah annuity lah, sebab dia tak ada regular payment. Okay, so tak ada potongan secara dalam masa yang sama. Okay, and then another one which is installment payment. So pinjaman apa semua tu yang kita bayar tiap-tiap bulan. Okay, so regular payment. Okay, so this one, what is ordinary annuity certain? Payments are made at the end of each payment interval. Okay, so katakan bayaran pada tiap-tiap bulan, monthly. So monthly, tiap-tiap bulan we have one, ni tarikh dia lah, 1, 2, 3, 4 dan sampai 28, 29, 30 or sometimes sampai 31. Okay, So the payment made at the end of each payment interval. Okay, so kalau bayaran bulanan, dia akan buat bayaran pada hujung bulan. Okay, so if the payment for each 3 month, so January, February, March, April, May, June, and so on. Okay, so payment made at the end of 3 month. Okay, so bayaran dia buat secara berkala selama 3 bulan. So bayaran 3 bulan. So pada hujung ni dia akan bayar hujung bulan 3 dan hujung bulan 6 dan seterusnya hujung bulan 9, hujung bulan 12. And another one, interest and payment period are of the same interval. Okay, so dia sama macam interest, dia sama macam dalam compound interest. We have what we call it semi-annually, compounded quarterly. So dia punya interval untuk payment dengan interest ni sama. For example, if compounded semi-annually. Okay, so semi-annually. Okay, so semi-annually, the interest and the payment are made on the 6 months. Okay, so 1 year, 2 times. So January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. So semi-annually, setahun, setiap every 6 months. So 6 months here and another 6 months is here. Okay, so payment here, payment and interest also here. And here also another payment and interest also kat sini. Okay. Ni akan sama. Interest dengan payment ni, dia sama. Okay, so future value of annuity. Ni tadi contoh yang saya cerita tadi. So RM100 is deposited every year for 5 years at 6% compounded annually. Okay, so deposited every year. Okay, so setahun dia deposit pada setiap-tiap tahun. Setahun deposit 100. 2 tahun deposit 100. 3 tahun deposit lagi 100. 4 tahun lagi 100. 5 tahun akan lagi 100. And then the interest also 6% compounded annually. Okay, so tiap-tiap tahun. Okay, setahun. So setiap tahun kat sini dapat interest. 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 Okay. Okay, so for each deposit this one, the money that already deposit for each year this one will produce its future value, its own future value. Okay, so 100 ni dalam jangka masa 5 tahun dia akan menghasilkan interest dan future value dia this one. This one also same for the second year, third year, fourth year and fifth year. Okay, so ni cara kira guna compound interest. Okay, so kata tiap-tiap tahun dapat interest, tapi kenapa kira sekali je? Yes, because this one power of 4. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So dalam compound interest, so dalam jangka masa 5 tahun ni, so dia akan dapat sebab kita kira future value pada tahun kelima lah. So yang ni tak terkira, tak dikira lah. Bukan. Daripada 100 ni, okay, so bagi ke 2 tahun, jangka masa dia setahun. So setahun, 2 tahun, 3 tahun, 4 tahun. So kuasa 4. And here so same, setahun, 2 tahun, 3 tahun, kuasa 3. Ni pun sama, setahun, 2 tahun, kuasa 2. Yang ni masa dia setahun saja, kuasa 1. And this one already here, dia tak pergi mana-mana. So cuma 100 lah, dia tak dapat, dia tak menghasilkan interest lah pada tahun kelima ni. Okay, okay, so if you analyze from this one, okay, so you will have this kind of formula. Okay, so ni tadi saya cerita, takkan kita nak kira satu-satu kan. So dia akan jadi panjang nanti. Okay, so therefore from this, actually from geometric series. Okay, so geometric series. Okay, so the future values of the annuity. Okay, so korang akan dapat formula ni. So you will have this formula. Okay, so S and which is R here, Okay, 100 this one is R, which is periodic payment. Maksudnya dia bayaran secara berkala tiap-tiap tahun ni, R. And then I is the interest compounded at each period. So interest dia tadi 6%, so 0.06. And then this one N, number of payments or number of interest payment, which is N equal to M times by T. Okay, so yang ni tadi saya salah kat sini ni. Okay, so 6% compounded annually. So this one should be divided by 1. Okay, so ni sepatutnya bahagi dengan 1. Ni pun sama 1. 1 dan sini 1. He also same 1 1 1, and he also 1. So yang lain samalah. So this one also become 1, and this one also become 1. Okay, so saya start. Okay, so ni yeah, future value. Okay, so kalau kita tengok future value, so setiap deposit ni kita akan tarik ke hadapan, dia akan pergi ke depan. So nanti ada lagi satu, we call it as present value. So present value structure dia macam ni, tapi dia akan tarik ke belakang, dia patah balik ke belakang. So nanti kita tengok. So first, we study first about the future value. Okay, and here normally this formula, the formula for the future value, usually we use for total saving and accumulated amount of unpaid payment. Okay. Okay, so total saving ni biasalah kita simpan, invest. So kita nak cari dia punya future value. This one accumulated amount of unpaid payment ni, kita biasanya berhutang lah. So berhutang, bayaran ni katakan bayaran tiap-tiap bulan lah. So this one kat sini tak bayar, sini bayar, sini tak bayar, sini pun tak bayar, dan sini pun tak bayar, dan kita nak bayar dekat sini. So this one all of 3, this one yang kita tak bayar ni sebanyak 3 kali ni, all of this one kita akan tarik pergi ke depan ni. Okay. So because kita tarik ke depan, so we use S. Okay. So nanti dia akan ada lagi satu, settle the debt early. So dia nak selesaikan hutang awal. So nanti yang tu kita akan tarik ke belakang. Itu akan pakai present value. Okay, so example here. Find the amount of an annuity of 350 payable at the end of each month for 5 years if the interest rate is 9% compounded monthly. Okay, lagi satu nanti banyak-banyak soalan, biasanya korang selalunya jumpa compounded monthly lah. Okay, so bayaran hutang apa semua biasanya dalam bayaran bulanan. Tapi ada je lah yang compounded quarterly apa semua. So 350 payable at the end of 3 month and the interest compounded quarterly, ada je. Okay. Okay, so for this one, 350 payable at the end of each month. So tiap-tiap bulan bayar 350. So meaning that this one is periodic payment, and this one 5 years, which is T, and then this one 9%, which is K, 0.09, and compounded monthly, so we have M, which is equal to 12. Okay, so substitute into the formula of future value of annuity. So we have S is equal to R, which is 350. Okay, so in bracket, another bracket, 1 plus the interest 0.09 divided by 12. Okay, so K divided by M. And then here N, which is M times by T. Okay, so setahun dia bayar 12 kali, ataupun interest dikira sebanyak 12 kali setahun. Since the time is 5 years, so dalam 5 tahun, so total semua sekali, jumlah berapa kali yang dia bayar adalah 5 kalikan dengan 12, which is 60. And then minus by 1, divide by 1 plus, salah formula. Divide by 0.09 over 12. Okay, so the answer is RM 26,398.45. Okay, so nanti kalau dalam kalkulator korang nak tekan, kalau nak tekan serentak 350 and then buat bracket, and for the numerator this one also you put bracket. Okay, so buat sebiji macam ni. Okay, so tu yang kalkulator yang hitam tu lah, yang putih tu tak ada masalah. Okay, so another question. RM150 was invested every month. Okay, so invested every month. So predict payment, bukan payment lah, predict deposit. Okay, so invested every month. So meaning that this one is R. In an account that pays 8.4% compounded monthly. Okay, tengok. Invested every month. Okay, so dia masukkan duit tiap-tiap bulan. Interest pun tiap-tiap bulan 8.4% compounded monthly. Okay, so this one K, which is equal to 0.084, and this one compounded monthly M, which is equal to 12, and this one for 2 years, so T is equal to 2. After 2 years no more deposit was made, so find the amount in the account at the end of 5 years. Okay, so ni time dia, so this one 2 years. Okay, so this one each month tiap-tiap bulan dia masukkan 150 150 150 selama 2 tahun ni. So tak tahu ada cukup tak. Okay, so after that and for another 3 years, dia dah tak masukkan deposit lah. Okay, so kenapa 3 tahun? Sebab because the question find the amount in the account at the end of 5 years. So selama 5 tahun, sini 2 tahun, so sini 3 tahun. So find the amount, so we need to find S here. What is S? Okay, so for the first 2 years, so this one is annuity because dia ada periodic payment ni. Setiap bulan dia bayar 150 ataupun invest banyak 150. Tapi yang sini tak ada. So maksudnya duit dia ada dekat sini je. So kat sini, yang kat sini ni selama 3 tahun dia akan berkembang-perkembang lagi. So for this 3 years, for the last 3 years this one, so we use compound interest. Okay, so this one annuity. Okay, so for the annuity, okay, so for 2 years, so we find here the future value here S. Okay, so cari S kat sini dulu. So the future value here S, which is 150 times by 1 plus the interest 0.084 divided by 12 because compounded monthly. And then here power of M times by T, 2 times 12, and then minus by 1 divided by 0.084 over 12. So the answer is RM 3905 ringgit and 24 sen. Okay, so this one 3900, this one here kat sini. Okay, so 3905 ringgit kat sini ni. So kita bawa lagi 3 tahun. So kita umpamakan this one become P lah. P which is equal to 3905.24. Okay, so kiranya macam kat sini ni permulaan untuk compound interest lah. Okay, so for another 3 years, so we have S which is equal to 3905.24 times with 1 plus 0 point, wait, tak muat lah. Okay, so S is equal to 3905.24 times with 1 plus 0.084 divided by 12 power of 2 times 12. So this one 3 years. So 3 times by 12. Okay, so interest dia still sama, dia tak berubah. Okay, so 3 tahun and the interest compounded monthly. Okay, so 3 times by 12. So we have here RM 5020 ringgit and 16. Okay, so another question. RM280 deposited every month for 6 years. If interest offer is 12% compounded monthly, how much is the total amount of the savings at the end of the period? Okay. So this one deposited every month. Tiap-tiap bulan dia depositkan 280. So meaning that this one become R. And then for 6 years, this one become T, value of T. And interest offer is 0.012. Okay, so K is 0.12. And then compounded monthly, so this one M is equal to 12. Okay, so tengok interest dia compounded monthly. Duit yang dideposikan pun setiap bulan. Okay, so how much is the total amount of the saving at the end of the period? Okay, so we need to find the future value at the end of 6 years. So S is equal to R, which is 280, and then in bracket 1 plus 0.12 divided by 12, power of 6 times by 12, then minus by 1 divided by 0.12 divided by 12. Okay. Okay, so yang lagi satu, tolak satu ni untuk semua ni sekali. All of this one minus by 1. Okay. So bukan kuasa dia yang ditolak satu. Okay. So sebelum ni saya ajar student ada yang dibuat kuasa ni tolakkan dengan satu. Okay. So yang tu salah. Okay. So actually all of this one minus by 1. Okay. So the answer is RM29,318.78. Yeah, so next BA4, number 4, question number 4. Encik Abdul invested RM150 every month in an investment scheme. So find the accumulated amount of the investment at the end of 5 years if the interest rate is 9% compounded monthly. Okay, so 150 every month. So this one become R. So sebab tiap-tiap bulan dia invest banyak 150, and find the accumulated amount of the investment at the end of 5 years. So this one become T. If the interest rate, okay, so this one become K, which is 0.09 compounded monthly, which is M equal to 12. Okay, so payment month every month, and the interest also compounded monthly, tiap-tiap bulan sama. Okay, so find the accumulated amount, which is S, equal to 150 in bracket 1 plus the interest 0.09 divided by M, which is 12, power of, okay, so setahun 12 kali, dan dalam masa 5 tahun kita ada 5 times by 12 minus by 1 divided by 0.09 over 12, so which is equal to RM11,313.62. Okay, so yang lagi satu bawah ni pun letak bracket dalam calculator nanti. Saya lupa nak cakap. Okay, so this one bracket, he also bracket. Okay, so this one also put in bracket. Okay, so number 5, find the equal monthly deposit made at the end, at the rate of 4.5% compounded monthly, that will amount to 2,000 at the end of 3 years. Okay, so dalam masa 3 tahun, so 3 years, okay, so the money will be amount RM2,000. Okay, so duit yang didepositkan ni kita tak tahu berapa. So, dalam jangka masa 3 tahun menjadi 2,000. Okay, so we need to find R. Okay, so the interest rate is 4.5%. T, 3 years and compounded monthly, which is M, is equal to 12. Okay, so we need to find R. So this one is S. Okay, so S is 2,000. R times with 1 plus 0.045 divided by 12 power of 12 times by 3 minus 1 divided by 0.045 over 12. Okay, so what is the answer? Okay, so we need to find R. So this one we bring to the left first. Okay, so 2000, this one here divide, so 2000 times with 0.045 over 12, so we have 7.5, which is equal to 1 plus 0.045 over 12 times by 3, which is 36 minus by 1. And then R is equal to, so here multiplication, okay. So bawa semua ni, bawa pergi ke sebelah, become divide. So 7.5 divide by 1 plus 0.045 over 12 power of 36 minus 1. Okay, so this one put bracket. So it is equal to RM 51 ringgit and 99 sen. Ya, ada soalan. So macam mana nak pindah-pindah ni? So kalau nak pindah-pindah, okay, so first tengok ni, saya bulatkan. So this one bawah ni dia bahagi untuk semua ni sekali kan. So bila korang pindah yang bawah ni, so tengok dalam bulatan ni ada apa-apa tak yang lain, yang lain luar daripada bulatan. Tak ada kan. Ni R, R ni pun sebenarnya R darab this one. Okay, so meaning that this one divide all of this one semua sekali. So tak ada yang kat luar daripada bulatan yang atas ni. So maksudnya kita pindahkan betul. Okay, contoh yang lain, katakan nak pindah negatif 1. So apa yang ditolakkan dengan negatif 1 ni? So yang ditolakkan dengan negatif 1 yang ni, bulat ni. So kalau korang pindah negatif 1 pergi sebelah, salah. Sebab yang ditolakkan negatif 1 adalah bulat ni, yang bawah ni tak kena, betul. So bila korang pindah negatif 1, dia akan jadi salah. Okay, so next, interest. So the interest for the future value in annuity, so we need to calculate by using this formula, which is I equal to S minus by N times by R. Okay, so kenapa jadi macam ni? Because of this one. Okay, so ni duit yang korang bayar. Okay, so kat atas, kat belakang ni kita ada S, which is our money. Okay, so the total of our money with the interest. So dalam ni kita ada our money and interest. Okay, so to, in order to calculate this interest, so from S we need to minus our money. Okay, so kita kena tolakkan dengan duit kita. So duit kita kat sini ni, so berapa banyak kita bayar, berapa kali kita bayar, kalikan dengan R. Tiap-tiap satu ni kita bayar berapa. Okay, okay, so this one example, Lena pays a cooperative 300 at the end of each quarter for 5 years. So each quarter, so quarter meaning that M is equal to 4. Okay, the cooperative pays an interest of 10% compounded quarterly. Okay, so sama, quarter, quarterly. This one also M is equal to 4, and this one K is 0.1, and T is equal to 5. Okay, so the, at the end of the 5 years period, so find the amount she has with the cooperative. Okay, so dalam masa 5 tahun ni, berapa jumlah yang dia ada? So we need to find the future value lah. So AS, which is equal to, okay, periodic payment dia R, which is 300. in bracket 1 plus interest 0.1 divided by 4. So setahun 4 kali, so kalau 5 tahun 5 times by 4 minus by 1 and then divide by 0.1 over 4. So this one the answer for S, which is equal to RM 7,663.40. Okay, so ni S kat ujung kita punya duit dengan interest. Okay, B, find the amount of interest C received. So for the interest, we need to subtract from the future value minus by our money, which is N times by R. Okay, so S is 7663.40. Okay, so setiap quarter kita bayar 300. So setahun kita bayar 4 kali. So kalau 5 tahun kita bayar sebanyak 20 kali. Minus by 20. Okay, so sekali setiap kali tu, setiap sekali kita bayar 300. So kalau 20 kali, so 20 times by 300. Okay, so we have total interest which is equal to RM 1,663.40. Okay. Yes, I think that's all for our lesson. So next time I will continue with the present value for annuity. Okay, so thank you and Assalamualaikum.